Hello everybody, welcome back to ScratchForFun, and today we are back modding some more. Let's just jump right into it, shall we? Today we shall go into our talent entity and work some more on the read from NBT and write to NBT. We're going to start with a write NBT. If we have time, we're going to do read from NBT as well. So first thing we're going to do is we're going to say super.writeToNBT, going to give it the default NBT or the argument NBT here, and this basically says okay, do what you normally do when you do writeToNBT. What do all of the classes do by default, basically? And after that we're going to say NBT.setShort. Now what is a short? Well, this will basically be our kind of integer, okay? This integer, we need to give it a name, and we need to basically, now we're basically going to save our variable, okay? We're going to save the variable as a short, okay? So I'm going to save, first of all, save the burn time variable. Now this is not a short, this is an integer, so we basically need to cast this as a short, okay? Now this needs a name as well, okay? You can choose whatever you want, but when you write to NBT, or you basically need to grab the same name from NBT as you write to NBT. So if I do you know, this right here, I need to write the same name when I read it from the NBT, because it's basically saved with this name right here. But for the simplicity, I'm just going to say burn time. I'm going to do this with the same, only cook time, and we are going to say cook time. Okay, so now we're basically saving to NBT our burn time and cook time, saving it as burn time and cook time. Let's create a list, okay? Because we have a few variables up here, or a few item stacks that we need to save as well. And you know, that's basically the main thing you want to save. So we're going to create a list NBT tag list, okay? We're going to call it list, because why not? We're going to set it equal to a new NBT tag list. There we go. So we're going to loop through the amount of slots we got. We currently got 3 slots, but I know that some of you are actually, you know, moving along and creating your very own furnace with different kinds of slots, and that's basically what I want people to do. So we're basically going to grab the amount of slots, which is slots.length, and I'm going to say i++, so it will then loop through all of these slots. And what we basically want to make sure is that this slot is not equal. It's not equal to null, because if this slot is null, that basically means that there are no item here, and that basically means that we do not need to save it. So just forgot to import NBT tag list here. So yeah, if there are no item here, there's no need to save the item that's here. Okay, very simple. We're looping through all the items. We're checking if there are items here, we want to save them. So we're going to create a new NBT tag compound. There we go. Going to call it NBT let's just call it compound. There we go. Set it equal to a new NBT tag compound. Now, what we basically want to do is we want to set a byte this time. Okay, so we're going to grab our compound, there we go, a little bit hard to write out, and we're going to set byte. Okay, so we're basically storing a byte this time. Now we're going to store it as a string, of course. Let's just call it slot, and we're going to say byte, and we're going to cast this to a byte and I. Okay, so that's basically I we are saving here, and then we're going to grab our slot. Now in the item stack class, there is a method called write to NBT. Okay, now that will do some default stuff when you're writing an item stack to a NBT. Okay, it will basically save the amount of items and all the stuff like that, so we don't need to do that when we are saving our items. Saving, you know, the amount of items, the item ID, the item damage and stuff like that. So we're just going to say write to NBT. We're going to say our compound here, and then we're going to grab our list object here, and we're going to say append tag. Okay, and then we are again going to say compound. There we go. Okay, so later when we read from this right here, we can basically grab basically slots, because here we save each and every slot, column slots, and we are basically adding them to the compound basically, and we are writing the slots to this NBT tag as well. Now that's basically all you need to write a item to a NBT. Hopefully I explain it good enough. We grab a NBT tag. You know, here we're basically checking, okay, all the items, that's items and not just empty slots, we'll go through this right here. We'll first of all create a compound, and then we're going to set the byte for this compound. That's basically what you refer to it. So if we later, use a NBT to grab a slot, we will basically get this byte right here, okay? And then we can use this to grab our NBT when we know this number basically. So what we're going to do now is we're going to say NBT dot set tag. Okay, we're basically going to set a tag because we got our list here. We are adding stuff to this list. We are adding compounds to this list, or we're adding NBT tag compounds to this list. What we basically need to do now is we need to save this list right here. We need to add our list to NBT, okay? Because this is just a random list right here. What we need to do, we need to use this NBT we get up here when we are setting a tag. Or a tag, you know, it's basically... this right here is a tag basically, okay? This right here, I guess, is also a tag. And this is a variable, so we're storing burn time, calling it burn time, cook time, calling it cook time. So if we need to grab the cook time when we load up the world, we need to ask for cook time and burn time. We need also to ask for a short. When we want to grab items or all of the items in our item stack, what we first want to do is we want to we basically want to grab this list right here, okay? And when we got this list, we got all the compounds in this list, okay? And we can read out from there. Now there is also some other stuff I want to do. If we have a localized inventory name, this string right here, basically, if we can basically change this, I guess, with an anvil. I'm not sure about that, but I believe so. So if you've saved this, if you've changed this name with an anvil, we basically want to save your name. So if you've changed the name with an anvil, basically, I believe it means, then we're going to grab our NBT and we're going to set a string, or basically store a string. We're basically going to call this for custom name. You can also call it name. I don't care what you call it. And then we're going to store the string localized name. So yeah, that's all you need to do to write to NBT. We're basically storing the localized name to custom name. So later we need to grab the custom name. If we want our items, we need to grab the list called items. And from there we get, this list contains a lot of compounds, and these compounds we can basically read. Here we add the compounds, here we basically add stuff to the compound, and here we initialize this compound and basically give it a variable, or we're basically storing a variable in here. So yeah, we can probably take on read from NBT now. So we're going to start by doing the same. We're going to call the super read from NBT, going to give it our NBT. And then the first thing we want to do is we want to grab this list right here. So we're going to create a NBT tag list once again. List, there we go. We're going to call it list, and we're going to set it equal to new NBT dot, NBT dot, and we basically want to get this tag list. So it's up in our face right now. That is because it's an NBT tag list, and we are using a NBT tag list. Eclipse recognizes stuff like that. So we're basically getting a tag list this time. Now we need to basically give it a string. This string right here is basically the name we saved this list as. We saved this list down here as items. Save this list as items. So we basically need to write the exact same to grab basically this we are saving down here into our list. Now that we basically got this, we need to initialize first of all our slots. We make sure that we've initialized our array and everything like that. So going to initialize it. It's a array, so we can initialize it like so. And we basically need to initialize the array. We don't need to initialize the item stacks in the array. We only need to basically tell the size of this array. So the size is going to be this dot get size inventory. Pretty simple. And then we basically want to grab these compounds. Here out from this list and save it to the slots variable. Okay, so we're going to grab a for loop, or create rather, and a for loop. Going to create an integer, call it I, set it equal to 0, and as long as I is less than list dot tag count, that's basically how many tags do you have in this list. Right here, we're basically saving tags, right? We are saving tags. And so yeah, all of the, you know, all of the slots, that's items in there, will basically get added to the tag count, basically. So yeah, this is basically the amount of items we saved. Now, what we basically want to do, we want to do the the stuff we did down here. We're going to create an NBT tag compound. Compound, we're going to call it compound once again. We're going to set it equal to our list here. Now, what do we want to do now? We basically want to grab the tag at position, retrieves the tag at specified index from the list. So we basically want to give it an integer, and then it's going to give us a number basically. Now, what am I going to say? Well, we are basically grabbing, now creating a compound, okay? Now, we need to basically cast this, so we hover over, and we're going to cast it to a NBT tag compound. Because here it retrieves the tag now, we're not sure, is this a compound, is this a list? Well, we did down here save to a NBT tag compound, okay? Now, we're going to create a byte. Let's just call it for B, for byte. Let's set it equal to NBT, no, sorry, our compound. And we're going to say get byte, and we're going to call slot, okay? Because down here, we save in our compound, basically, we save slot, okay? We create a compound. Then we set a slot, and we basically set the variable I. We're storing variable I here into the NBT tag. And here we are retrieving this variable I down here, and we're storing it to the variable B, which is a byte. We're getting this by calling slot, which we saved it as. Okay. Now, I want to create an if statement. And if this B is larger than 0, okay, and B is less than this.slots.length. Now, as long as B is larger than 0, okay? Because right down here, we are saving the slot I'm not sure if... No, sorry. I wasn't sure why we would say it's greater than zero, because... You know, zero, we are using zero here, but yeah, it's greater or equal to zero, okay? So if this is zero, one or two... now we're saying less here, because if this slot... if we have three slots, it's basically going to be called 0, 1, and 2. And the length is 3. Okay? So the length is, you know, 3. And it's from 0 and above. So 0, 1, and 2. As you know, 0, 1, and 2 are all less than 3, which is the length. So just checking that so we don't grab any false stuff here. I'm going to grab the slots. The slot at position B, sorry, and we're going to set it equal to item stack. Now, down here we wrote to NBT using the a method in the item stack, and now we're basically going to use a static item stack called load item stack from NBT. We basically need to give it a we need to give it a compound, there we go, which is basically the item we are retrieving, and then it will, you know, grab, okay, this is the item ID, this is the, you know, the item damage, this is the, you know, back and forth and stuff like that, and when it knows which item it is, we basically save it to the slot here. Now, we did some more than just saving the slots here. We also did burn time, cook time, and custom name. So what we're basically going to do is we're going to set burn time equal to nbt.get short. We're going to get the short of burn time. Pretty simple. We're going to set this.cook time equal to nbt.get get short. There we go. And we're going to say cook time, and now we basically grab those two variables. Now we're going to say this.current item burn time. Now we didn't save this variable, but we do not need to, because we have a method called get item burn time. So now we're basically not grabbing anything from NBT, but we are basically going to grab the burn time of slot 1. Now that's why we are grabbing the slots first, because if we have the slots first, we can then say, okay, grab the current item burn time from slot number 1, which is the smelting slot, or the fuel slot rather. Now we also want to grab this right here. Now we are casting a for loop before we are setting this, so it's not 100% sure that we got this string saved. So we need to test this before we do anything, or we might get a null pointer exception. So what we're basically going to do is we're going to say nbt.hasKey, just to check, do you have the key custom name? That's what we saved it as down here. If it has the key custom name, we're going to set this.localizedName equal to nbt.getString, because now we know, okay, we want to get a null pointer exception, and we're going to say custom name. Now, if this is not working for you, you might have you might have spelled something wrong here, so make sure that you check this out. Let's quickly run this, shall we? Come on. Here we go. Here's Minecraft loading up everything. So this should work. Now we're going to. Yes, people have been asking me. I'm going to release the source code at the. Let's set the render distance out to far now. So I'm going to release the source code in the last video I create on this furnace. So this is my furnace right here. We still need to fix the texture. It is very darn simple. But yeah. Now, I can place down a furnace. I can I got some items in my inventory here. A coal and a log. And as you can see, it looks great. Let's place more logs in there. And it is working. The GUI is working. This is working. I'm just going to, do everything, and I'll tell you what's not implemented yet, because there's two methods now we have not implemented. But if I were to say, okay, when this arrow is midway here, we stop, run out, like so. Okay, so if we do not have a read and write this method right here we created today, when I log back in again, they should not, the item should not be there. But as you can see, the progress bar saved itself. Now this did not save itself. That's something we need to note. Now, of course, we cannot shift click. We're going to fix this quickly. Why did it not work? We did not get the burn time. Yes, I think that was the burn time. We're basically grabbing burn time. Yes, I'll have a look into it. Okay, so I've been doing a little bit of checking, and it looks like it is the same problem or the same bug with the normal furnace. Right now, this is not changing, this fire right here. Now, if I figure out what's wrong, why this is bugged, you know, I will, of course, let you know. Now, the vanilla Minecraft is a little bit bugged as well, and that's basically what I am reading from here. Now you can see this is falling very, very quickly. So yeah, there's a little bit of bugs in here. But we might be able to figure those out ourselves. Now, the only thing that's not happening here, we got our texture wrong. If I place an item in here and break it, the item is not popping out, and I cannot shift click stuff, okay? So that's what we're going to have to do. Thanks for watching, everybody. Thanks so much for watching, everybody. My name is ScratchFun, and I'll catch you guys in my next video. Goodbye, and have a nice day.